Invicta FC 15 officially underway. Both of these women standing right around 6 feet tall. Talking to teammates of Megan, Anderson sounds like she's really sort of settled into her size, using that reach a lot better since moving to the States in training.
She has, and she just popped a very, very nice jab after an attack there.
Hard right hand there by Leibrock. Anderson pressing forward still. Another hard right hand by Leibrock.
That right hand is going to be there unless she lifts her left hand just a little bit higher.
See Anderson coming forward, though. Very confident with her striking is the Aussie. Anderson putting punches together, or Leibrock, rather.
I like how much movement is coming from Leibrock. Oh, wow, she's really finding a home for that right hand.
Leibrock throwing with a lot of power, but it's not facing Anderson. Still hanging tough, standing inside the pocket is Megan. Leibrock switches it up and goes to the body.
Yeah, Megan looks calm and steady out there right now, pushing her up into the cage with her strikes.
One would think that Leibrock, oh, there she
goes. Oh, she's
hit her with the right hand, another with the left. Megan is rocked. Leibrock puts her up against the fence now. And the left hand there by Leibrock. Dirty boxing now.
And you can see Megan's trying to regain her composure right there. Spin Leibrock over so that her back is on the cage. Grabbing around the head like that, not always the best idea, though.
Nice standing elbow there by Leibrock. Megan answers with the right hand of her own. Now Leibrock on defense.
Megan's picking up that steam. Leibrock's getting a little bit crazy with those strikes right there, really rattling them off.
Oh, the first fight of the night. Leibrock and Anderson going to war here inside the Invicta FC cage.
Well, I don't think that there's any question that both of these young ladies can take a shot right now. Nice pressure from Anderson, trying to control with her forehead, you know, keep Leibrock up against the cage.
I was going to say Leibrock, you know, throwing a lot of power punches here, and Anderson was able to eat a lot of them early, but Leibrock did land a right hand that stumbled the Aussie, but now inside the clinch, I think both women trying to sort of regather and recalculate their approach.
You can see Leibrock's, her nose is bleeding a little bit right here, so some of those shots were really, really strong against her.
A lot of action here in the first half of this round, coming up on the halfway point. Anderson switches to a single leg here, see if she can get a takedown.
See if that wrestling practice. No, she abandons it, comes back up top here.
Leibrock with short right hands. We'll see if Amber tries to get off the fence, get back to space.
It looks as though Amber's trying to set up some sort of sweep or hip toss right there. Anderson's doing a good job of keeping her butt out, her butt farther out, so that her balance is not disrupted from that.
Anderson with that left underhook. See Leibrock trying to break the posture a bit, bringing her right knee up.
Now that head pressure is really, really key right now. That's working very, very well for Megan Anderson.
John McCarthy overseeing this fight. Steps in. A little bit of a stalemate there, especially with how heavy these women were throwing early in the round. Now 90 seconds left here in the opening frame.
You can see Leibrock's on her toes looking for that big right overhand. She knows she's got a home for that. And Anderson's doing a very good job of, even when she eats it, coming forward and getting that clinch, getting where she's more comfortable.
Fingers in her face. Anderson definitely taking over in these clinch sequences here up against the fence, forcing Leibrock into the cage, being more defensive in posture.
It's a smart fight to fight right there, keeping her pinned, slowing down that energy.
A lot of energy was expelled here in this first round. Both women came out throwing heavy leather. See Leibrock trying to maybe skid away. She's got that overhook on the right arm of Anderson. Would you like to see Leibrock try to maybe get better grip here? Now we see some more strikes here in the clinch.
Yes, when she's putting her foot up like that, she's definitely, you know, keeping Anderson from throwing knees to her midsection, but unfortunately it's also giving a single leg position. Now with her underhook or double leg, as you see Anderson drop right down there. Smart move by Anderson. Pick somebody up to take them down when they're against the cage. It's something that really works very, very well to get them off of that third rail that they're on. for balance.
Leibrock, very tall fighter here as well, up against the fence, not giving up that takedown easy, still on her feet.
And Anderson's head is in a very dangerous position right there. I think she can weather if a submission attempt is put there, but she actually, that's not a great place to put your head in a takedown attempt.
Under 10 seconds here. We'll see how the second round fares. A lot of energy expelled there. You know, look at Anderson, her shots come in quantity while Leibrock's come in, you know, just power.
Mm-hmm.
Megan rushing forward. Kick to the lead leg of Leibrock lands for Anderson.
Would be very nice to see both of these ladies hold their hands just a bit higher. Oh, nice overhand. You don't see a lot of shots going double right or double left like that, and it's very, very effective in striking.
Anderson lands that lead left kick or lead kick to the left leg of Leibrock, and Leibrock hasn't really checked it. She's been eating it pretty hard.
She has been. You know, I'm wondering about the amount of power in there, if she's just actually trying to take that so she can get that right hand. But that right hand is not phasing Anderson as much as I think Leibrock thought it would.
And that can be discouraging for a fighter when you hit someone, you know, in the first 10 seconds with all your power and they just eat it and keep walking forward. Yeah, that can definitely play with your psyche a little bit. But Leibrock did have some success in the early part of the first round, did rock Anderson a little bit, but the Aussie looks composed, looks to have recovered here in the second round.
She does, and you know, you might think this sort of grinding position is kind of difficult to watch from home. I understand that people get a little bit bored sometimes, but I will say it's exhausting for the other fighter who's up against the cage. It sucks to have somebody's forehead grinding into you, especially with braids. That's tough.
We've seen Anderson go for the takedown a couple times here in this fight. Now she's having to fend off getting pushed up against the fence.
That was an interesting disruption of balance right there for Leibrock. She almost had total positional, you know, I guess control right there with Megan on the fence, but she actually lost her balance in the exchange there.
And I brought up the takedown attempt by Anderson in the first part of the fight here. She actually took Cindy Dandewa down in their bout. Now, obviously, it didn't work out in her favor, but she is showing that she has the ability to take down her opponents and you know, take the fight where she wants to fight.
Now, if you look at the way Megan Anderson is kind of wrapping around the head like that, that can be very dangerous. Leibrock is responding. She's wrapping around over the top of Megan's hand, but in this position, both of their heads are actually, they can get to a position of exposure to get hit or just disrupt their balance and put them down. One of these girls is going to be put on her back if that kind of positional struggling continues.
Appreciate you joining us tonight on UFC Fight Pass, the first of many offerings from Invicta FC. If you want to join in on the conversation tonight, use the hashtag InvictaFC15 at TJ DeSantis at @JulesK_fighter. John McCarthy seeing enough against the fence, separates the two women, and here we are back in space. Left hand gets through there by Leibrock. There's that kick again, and that one affected Leibrock a little bit. Stumbled there, Julie.
It did. It made her stumble.
Look at Amber firing back with a kick of her own to the body.
Oh, nice. Really pushed her back, but she's doing very, very well.
Megan Anderson is finding some home for these strikes here up against the fence.
Nice.
Leibrock with a front kick.
Hey, let go of that leg. Let go of the leg. Let go of the leg. One, two. Uppercuts here.
It's Featherweight's putting on a show inside the hangar, Costa Mesa, California tonight. Julie Kedzie again with TJ DeSantis. That's me. Megan Anderson trying to bully Amber Leibrock here.
And I think it's actually working very effectively. She's grinding her, she's pushing her, she's breaking her down so that in the exchanges she can rattle off those nice kicks to the leg. You know, she can find a home for her own hands. Definitely Leibrock is still game in this fight, trying to get as many strikes as she can, trying to find those shots.
Beautiful standing elbow there by Anderson. Leibrock fires back with the right hand. Leibrock looking worse for the wear here, bleeding from the nose. Megan Anderson trying to bunch up some punches. Leibrock goes for a takedown. That might be indicative of where she's at right now after eating some of those strikes.
And that was a little bit of a desperation attack right there. You know, she didn't set that up with any strikes. She just kind of bulldozed forward. Didn't work in her favor because her back is now pinned up against the cage again.
Leibrock with her mouth wide open here, definitely breathing heavy as we're in the 9-minute mark of this contest. Taking a look at the clock is Leibrock trying to get a trip. Eats a knee, left knee high by Anderson. Very nice Muay Thai skills on display by the Aussie. She's landed that knee there as well as some standing elbows a moment ago. Definitely an onslaught of strikes, a variety of strikes by Megan.
Yes, I would say her move to America has done her some really, really good work.
That's the thing internationally, you know, throughout the world you can pick up good striking, but I think wrestling's home still in mixed martial arts is in the States, and Megan Anderson, you know, mixing up her striking and her grappling quite nicely here.
Yeah, and if you want to be a really good striker, don't fear the takedown. That's how you do it. Oh,
Amber
nice.
Leibrock eats a hard shot from Megan Anderson. Anderson being very calculated here. Final 10 seconds of this round. Leibrock initiates a clinch. That might save her here to participate in round number three. She definitely was hurt there a moment ago.
Yeah, this round was all Anderson.
Megan Anderson and Amber Leibrock. Anderson comes out very aggressive. Leibrock's still game though, front kick. Anderson coming back in, clinching up against the fence once more.
I love the way she's pushing on her and then throwing that elbow right off of that. That can really get some effective cutting going. Nice little, you know, attempt at a jump knee right there. When you're in bad situations, kind of just go for broke, throw what you have. But right now, you know, Leibrock is definitely not getting the upper hand. Oh, and she tries for a trip right as I say that, but unfortunately, she's on the bottom again.
The takedown didn't go her way, but it shows the heart of Amber Leibrock. She came to win this fight, and she's not going to stop until she is out of it. Now look at that.
Nice.
Trying to get a high guard here is Leibrock. She does. Now let's not forget, Megan Anderson was triangle choke when she fought Cindy Dandois.
Yeah, she puts herself in bad positions sometimes with her head, and Leibrock is very aware of that, and she's trying to climb up, you know. Strategically, it's not a bad thing to kind of tie somebody up like this and keep their striking down with a broken posture.
Now, Leibrock trying to frame up that triangle. The hand is not totally cleared of Anderson here. I got to make sure she's got to make sure to swim in, right, Julie? She wants to try to dive back in and try to disrupt the angle of this choke.
Yeah, she does want to dive back in. She's doing a good job of defending if an armbar would follow after this, but she really needs to keep herself actually as crunched as she can. To get posture, her other shoulder's got to be between her legs.
Megan Anderson trying to put her new training on display here. This is that same position she found herself in with Cindy Dandois when Dandois got the win last September in Kansas City. So for now, Megan Anderson doing what she needed to do against Cindy Dandois, and still staying in this fight despite fending off a triangle.
Yeah, I think that's not a bad idea. You know, let her exhaust herself a little bit. You know, get to a position where you can posture and step right back out.
Nicely done by Megan Anderson, able to stand back up, and she invites Leibrock back to the feet.
Very smartly done there. Oh,
beautiful head kick.
Kick
by Megan Anderson. Megan with another knee to the head of Leibrock. Yeah, the action has not slowed here. The power might not be there as it was earlier in the fight, but these women still very game for putting in plenty of work here. 2.5 minutes remain here in the final round.
Now watch the way she's controlling her posture. She's pushing on the head like that.
Leibrock in trouble here. That's it.
Oh.
Megan Anderson claims her first Invicta FC victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 2:33, round number three. Referee John McCarthy puts a halt to the bout. TKO by strikes for your winner, Megan.